Even if I get the first rank, somebody from Andhra got 50% qualification mark, even they got 7th or 8th rank, they will be selected. Mm. That is the rules over there now. I'd make one decision. I should not do cardiac surgery in Tamil Nadu. Actually, I discussed before marriage only. I told her that I will be doing cardiac surgery. Yeah. His life will be like that. If you are okay, just marry me. I discussed issues already with her and she knows that life will be demanding and challenging.
So how did you progress from internship is what when you met him, right?
Then
so
your progress stopped there.
That is a sad story of many.
So one of the thing I feel guilty also because of me. Okay, I ruined that.
You feel guilty all the time. I'm so happy this afternoon, Sunday afternoon in Madurai, sitting in Dr.Gopi Nallaiyan's house and to meet Dr.Gopi Nallaiyan and Hemapriya. And I'm sure some of you have seen a recent article in Learning General Surgery about the yeoman service they're doing to children, pediatric age group with cardiac surgical abnormalities and correcting them as a social service. And when I came to Madurai, I thought I should somehow meet Gopi, and then I called him on a Sunday, hesitating to disturb him, but then he was too forthcoming and very, very happy to receive us. So nice meeting you both, and welcome to Learning General Surgery. You know, the routine story will be childhood, this, that and the other, but I think, where did both of you meet? How did you come together? What brought you together?
Sir, first of all, thank you for considering us for the interview. So it's not like Sunday. This is the day we are also free, so that it is a good opportunity for us also. Regarding your question, we met in the ward in GRH. She is my intern. I was doing my postgraduate MS gender surgery.
Really? Yeah, the routine story.
So there we met and...
What impressed you? I can ask that same question to her also as to why. What did you see special? Because, you know, the chemistry working is not very, very... Chemistry work to start with, but then the chemistry phases away after a while.
So, something was charming and she was attractive to me. Probably the same worked for her also.
Okay.
So, we are there working together for 1.5 months postings,
right.
Surgical posting
okay.
was there. So, that period we are, it's not like a, we are regular relationship was there, like PG and intern relationship was there. But slowly it got changed, we became more affectionate, more caring towards her.
Right.
And suddenly once he finished the 6 weeks posting, I felt lonely.
a sign of love sickness.
Some sickness happened and so that way we realized that and I felt that she will be, I will be comfortable if I am with her for a lifetime.
Okay,
so,
okay.
So somewhere.
So one love and that's all. How about you? What impressed you in him?
He was very cool and very simple actually, and forthcoming in all. He's very sincere and very sincere in his work.
Mm-hmm.
Like even the staffs used to tell, if it is Dr. Gopi's duty, then we don't have any trouble. He's used to be very sincere.
I think that is the most important. When the nursing staff and others will say that, I heard about another surgeon recently, and the said that if Dr. Muthu is there, there's no fear, you know, something like that. Right, then?
So, and also very simple and helpful, like for everyone. So, I thought maybe he'll be the right person. But it was not immediate, it was a long, it took some time.
And everybody agreed to it, there's no opposition.
No, we had trouble.
Hmm.
But then they were okay with that after an year or so.
Right.
So then we got married only. He told he will marry only after he got his MCH.
Okay.
So this was in the second year of MS.
Right.
So I waited for around 2.5 years. Once he got his MS, MCH, then we got married.
So where did you do your MBBS and what made you to take up medicine as a career?
MBBS I did from Tanjore Medical College.
Okay.
MBBS of Tanjore Medical College. Actually, I didn't wish to do medicine at all.
Yeah.
I was bland. I was there is no like these youngsters in this generation. I don't have any idea about going medicine, engineering or something. Just I lived my life studying this thing, everything. But my mother and father want me to be a doctor.
Why?
I don't know. They are passionate about that.
Okay, okay.
So even I got a good marks in engineering stream also. Good cutoff was there.
Right.
Those days it was not counseling. We have to fill the thing and so I got allotted Tanjore Medical College on fine day. It was in the paper. We saw our entrance number was there. I was allotted Tanjore Medical College. And so that time I just made it.
So if you wouldn't have got into medicine, where will you go to? What will you be?
I have still no idea.
Ray is a very cool chap. He is not very, very bothered about. Because when we were here,
During January, March was the exam. So during January, I got interested towards medicine because it was brainwashed by my parents. You have to become doctor for last 2 years, plus one itself. I was started neglecting the max also.
Right.
So I was not preparing well for the max entrance exams also. So I was mentally made up to take the decision, but I was not very keen on taking up medicine. And my father and mother are deciding if I don't get, let him do improvement 1 year. They were in that kind of attitude then. Then I was frightened. I told them clearly, if I don't get medicine, I will take some other field. I'll take a veterinary doctor. I will become a veterinary doctor. Even if I don't get BVSC, I will become a horticulture or some other agriculturist to BSc. Whatever the science stream I will get. But don't ever force me to study this book again.
So that's a real cool way. So, at what juncture while doing MBBS you realize that, oh, I've taken the right decision?
No, first year it was hectic. Yeah. We were the first non-semester batch, 1997.
Okay. Right.
At the end of the first year, we have to complete anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, all three you have to complete. Yeah. So that it was hectic.
Right. Yeah.
I didn't have any time to think about why I got medicine and why it's right or not also I didn't. After second year, we started clinical postings. Then only I realized, okay, this is cool and started liking the specialty. So when I was starting in medicine posting, surgical postings, so we feel that we are doing something, we are studying something apart from other degrees.
Right.
So I feel we are different and we have to do something, we have to learn as per the thing and we have to do service to the societies. So I will discuss with my engineering friends and other friends and all school friends. There will be constant touch in first year, second years. That time I feel that I am better than them. I have chosen better degree than them.
Great.
First year I will be thinking that we should have taken engineering. Once I started the clinical posting, started seeing the patients and this thing, interacting with the patients, and so I feel that I have taken a right choice and that the universe has. Whatever the thing, forcefully I got to take medicine, but it is good for everything only, I feel that.
I think the gene was there inside of some social service because you thought there is some service you are doing to human beings as a doctor and not anybody else. And who impressed you in Tanjore Medical College, your teachers, colleagues, anybody sort of inspired you also made you feel that this is the right profession for you?
No, it's not right profession. There are very good teachers, medicine in those days. I don't know about these days. There are very, very, very good teachers, dedicated teachers. They come before us to the OPD, even after the chief professors and HODs will come by 7:30. Those days from 7 to 7:30, it was OPD, timings was changed. So 7:30 they will come to OPD and take classes in the OPD. They will discuss enumerate number of points and even ward if you go there also lot of classes. So there were dedicated teachers, medicine, surgery, obstetrics, pediatrics, ortho, everywhere there are dedicated bunch of teachers in the Tanjore Medical College. So everybody has played their own role that okay, we have to learn something, we have to do the thing, we have to excel in this specialty, excel in this field, so that we can do make wonders in the people, change the lives of the people. So that a lot of teachers, I can't name one or two. So in each and specialty, everything, there are excellent teachers were those times.
See, they are excellent teachers only when they are excellent students. They are
no
excellent students, they are not excellent teachers.
One thing, I am very average student.
You have to agree with the statement. You agree with that? So how did you get into medicine? No.
Same thing, only forced by parents. I actually had to do the improvement also. I got in Bits Bilani. I so wanted, and also REC also.
There also there's something similar between both of you. Didn't want to, but parents forced you.
I got in REC also. They didn't want to let me. They forced me to do improvement, and then I did improvement and then joined.
Okay. You did from which college?
Madurai Medical College.
MBBS.
Mm-hmm.
And what were you dreaming of when you're doing MBBS that you should do what further in medicine?
I wanted to do dermatology.
Somebody wanted to do dermatology. Why? Easy life.
Easy life, yes.
Oh, okay.
No emergency.
Notice that is a demanding specialty, I think.
That is, but why did you want an easy life? Why you didn't have, where did you get the social service thing? Because dermatology is, you take it easy, relax at home, don't do night duties and cool life.
Service thing only after he started doing surgeries when we saw so many patients. Right. Then our life changed actually.
So, how did you get into general surgery? Why not general medicine or something else?
Actually, that itself an accident. I was during MBBS days, I was passionate about cardiac surgery. Those days,
how? Why?
I want to become a cardiac surgeon.
Why?
Those times,
was there a good cardiac surgeon in your hospital?
No, not cardiac surgeon. As fantasy type of thing.
Oh, okay. Right.
So those time during the pre-final years, final year, we were doing a lot of surgical work, and that too cardiac surgery. We can do wonders, we can touch the heart. So fascinating it was. So I want to become a cardiac surgeon those times. But after my clearing my MBBS, I have internship. First rotatory internship was in surgical posting. During that posting, I decided I should not do surgery. I left the option is cardiac surgery is out of question.
Why?
So we see lot of complications. There's some bad. It's not like one summer will make everything. So this thing and odd working hours and tiring work. This thing I felt till the MBBS night, it was like relaxed work was there. Suddenly one fine day they told me to post 24 hours duty and everything, and a lot of complications, colostomy, this thing, appendicectomy at night 1:30 is induced at 1:30 in the night. So and lot of RTAs will be coming, suturing it will be there. So I felt somehow that I should not, it's not a specialty for me because I am from a middle class background also. So it's better to take a medical field and set up a OP and do some
practice.
That was my thinking during that time, so that we can do the job quietly. So this is also teamwork. It's difficult to get a teamwork. You have to set up a hospital and you have to joining some hospital. So it was a good. So that time my mind was going to I'm interested in pediatrics that time.
Okay.
So I was thinking about dreaming about getting pediatrics.
Really?
During the internship period only.
Okay.
And I was attracted towards obstetrics also that time. So I was thinking whether I should take obstetrics or pediatrics. That was my aim to take a post-graduation degree. So
then how did you get into surgery?
So that we will be having a lot of difficulties during the preparing the PGs because my family is my support of the father. He is the only earning member. He is a central government employee. So my brother, I have an younger brother. He is also inspired by me. He joined BDS. So I told him, no, don't join MBBS. He told, no, I will. Well, you are studying MBBS, why you should also come to MBBS? But he didn't get it. After improvement also, little bit 0.5 mark was there. So he chosen the BDS. So my father, I never asked money from my father during internship.
Really?
That was 3,000 stipend will be there.
Oh, that's enough.
That's enough. That was quite, it was good enough.
You didn't have a girlfriend by
that time. It was not that.
Oh, then it's okay. Yeah.
So my dad started feeling okay. He started earning on his own. Suddenly one Friday after completing the thing, I want to study, give me some money. And then he felt frustrated. Already everybody, your friends are finished 2 years back only degree and joined some work or doing some other work. You are finished late and now you are asking money for your survival. You should work and do some work and study. So that time my mother convinced him and it's difficult to get PG seats nowadays. They have to prepare. And during your internship, I never touched the book. Many of my friends read the book.
You didn't read any entrance?
No, that time it was not.
You're not planning to go any further?
No, we have planned, but I want to learn practical work more. There is some group of friends are there. They will be very, very, and whenever we get free time, we'll go to movie or something like that. So that's not in our mindset to sit and prepare for the entrance exams. That time also a lot of my colleagues, friends will be reading the MCQs and this thing. So it was not an mindset. We have planned, okay, 1 year we'll keep for that.
Okay.
So that is a separate type of
but
work.
But 1 year your father has to feed you.
No, that time I didn't realize that. My father also was not told anything about, because I was not asking any money from him, and we are also having very good time and we are enjoying doing the, even when we are free now, I will go to OG. Okay. Whenever my friend is there in OG postings, I will go there.
Okay.
We'll go out, support, we'll do the work over there right. And finish off the dues, everything, finish off the work and we'll go out somewhere.
Okay.
So it's like our group of friends are like that. So we'll help each other and we'll finish off the work first and we'll, it's not like only during surgery posting, I'll be learning surgery or something like that. We'll do, whenever there is a LP puncture is there, we'll go on.
Yes.
I will help him. He will ask me, I have not done, you have finished your medicine posting, come, we'll do.
Right.
We'll share the work and we'll learn the things. We thought that studying entrance is a different aspect and we can learn this practical aspect.
But Tanjavur boys are very good, by and large. If they write their entrance, they'll get it. Isn't that true? So then how did surgery come into the picture?
No, during my preparation, I had a lot of entrance exams, a lot of these things, and I got some 300 rank, odd rank in Tamil Nadu PG, and some 1,500 or 1,700 in All India. So those rank night was only diploma was available, master degree was available, and I got in Banaras Hindu University. I wrote Banaras Hindu University in
BHU,
Varanasi. I wrote the entrance. I got a good amount, 23 or something rank there. I thought that I will get some. There are only master degrees there.
Okay.
No diplomas during that time.
Okay.
So that my counseling, my entrance, Tamil Nadu counseling is today and day after tomorrow is BHU counseling.
Right.
So it was slash like that. So I have to submit the certificates if I choose some degree here.
Okay.
If I put waiting list, there is no need for any submitting certificates. So that I can catch the evening 6 o'clock train, that Ganga Kaveri Express was
okay.
There. So my session was 12 to 2, 1 o'clock it was there. So at that time I see whatever the thing available, all my, some ENT was there. Only ENT was there, general surgery is third, at 4 waiting list and DCH was waiting list. Pediatrics was my next option and other master degrees are finished. All other diplomas were there. So I was, that time my aim was to put some waiting list.
So
I thought general surgery will be the waiting list. It is the mobile waiting list I was thinking. I was not affordable to spend one more year also for PGs also.
Okay.
So I was putting a DCH, there will be most competition, it won't move there, somebody was telling an MS, there is a chance for movement is there, master degree, and they told. So I put fourth waiting list in MS.
So MS. Movement is the reason.
So that time it's not like focused, our vision is not very wide, it was
true.
To tide over that thing.
Okay, then you went to BHU.
I was sure of getting some master degree, but I was sure of getting obstetrics.
Mm-hmm.
Two seats was there because 38 seats was there, I was 23 ranks. But somehow my bad luck obstetrics was taken by two of them. Okay. And institute candidate, some of the institute, it was collected for institute quota and something happened over there. I was getting dermatology and master degree and ENT, same ENT and dermatology. And other non-clinical facility.
Okay.
So I was forced to take either these two or non-clinical. That time dermatology I was not interested. So it's like a very vast specialty and I was not interested basically. And ENT also I don't want to. And this also pulmonology also was there.
Oh, okay.
MD pulmonology was there. Mm-hmm. So I was a little worried about I didn't took the thing. And I came back this general surgery mood.
No, you came back, right? How are you sure this will move? Because if it doesn't move, you are neither here nor there.
No, what is the problem? I have many of my colleagues has taken general surgery in all India and left the here MD anesthesia, some okay. End specialty, ortho they got.
Oh, okay.
Even my Tanjore Medical College, two of us was there. And one of my friend, actually schoolmate, he studied in Stanley Medical College. He also chose general surgery in All India quota.
Okay.
Now he got MD Pediatrics.
Okay.
Out of that, for two, surely I know that two of the All India quota will be given back to Tamil Nadu.
Okay. Yeah.
So two movement already is there during the counseling itself.
Okay.
So I was thinking for, and after that BHU rank, I was a little bit confident, okay. We can have a good knowledge about the subject now, so we can next attempt, even after working also, I can take sure shot in next All India.
Okay.
And All India also, I got some diploma seats.
Mm-hmm.
I took some JIPMER, I took diploma in leprosy, I took the seat.
Really?
I took the seat, that is for the purpose, I can have some safe thing and I will study for the entrance.
Okay.
So I will join the seat and if I leave, in between, if I get the All India next year, I can leave like that, I was thinking. But I went there and enquired and the dermatology department was cursing me, seeing me.
Why?
So many people are taking the seat, leaving in between, okay, like the diploma of leprosy seats. Yeah. MD dermatologist and so on. Say they told.
Jay Shankar must be there.
I don't know. That,
my classmate. Chief
actually,
of
some of the MD dermatology PG I met, one of the lady PG only, she told that, please don't take if you're not interested. Please don't join if you're not interested. At least if you don't join, some other person will join. And then I feel that is also right from their point. I saw from her point, okay, we are shortage of doing duty. So if you leave after 2 or 3 months, it will be difficult for us. And so then I felt that, okay, we have to, should not join like this and waste the seat. I feel I didn't join that. So luckily I got a mood and I had option of I got an option also, two seats in Tanjore, two seats in Madurai, where you are going, they asked me.
Well, you would choose Madurai, Tanjore, that is your parent call.
There also
they would have met her.
There also I made a mistake.
Is a mistake? I think till now you didn't make any mistakes. You didn't take leprosy when that girl said please.
What is that? I told you, I had a bad experience in gender surgery internship. With that experience, I didn't took. I don't want to do in Tanjore.
Really?
So I want to do okay because that those time na Stanley and Madurai are good colleges. It was Stanley is the best for surgery as far as I can say. Still, it is it holds true I think. And I got an option for Madurai, so I took Madurai that time.
Okay.
And joined in
but
Madurai.
Is Madurai far from your home or Tanjore?
No, I was staying in Salem. My home is in Salem. Oh. Salem. It's both similar, equidistant okay. From the okay. Tanjore also okay. 4 hours, 3.5-4 hours it will take, and Madurai also same distance. So my father was working at Salem at that time. So that makes no difference for me. Anyway, I have to be in hospital.
So how did you progress from internship is what when you met him, right?
Then
so
your progress stopped there.
That is a sad story of many.
So one of the thing I feel guilty also because of me. Okay, ruined that.
You feel guilty all the time. So how was your surgical training in Madurai?
It was okay. It was not very great.
What is great?
Once I told you, after joining surgery and I felt that surgery is my specialty, that day I decided I have to become a cardiac surgeon.
Okay.
Again, my thought has come because I left cardiac surgery because I don't want to be a surgeon. But the destiny made me a surgeon, and I have to do lung surgery, I have to be a surgeon. Then that day I made my decision that I have to be a cardiac surgeon.
Right.
So that is my destiny is taking towards my cardiac surgical program.
So, but from Madurai, then when you wanted to become a cardiac surgeon, you must have had some idea as to how to go about, where to join, which are the places, how do you, till now there was no planning. You took what came. And if somebody requested not to take, you didn't take. So then on you started thinking as
After surgical training, I was doing planning to take, I was analyzing where to, what, how to do, where to do. I had to make one decision. I should not do cardiac surgery in Tamil Nadu. So
did she agree to it?
She knows that, and I just I told
her. You discuss his career, how to work.
After because
that's very boring to discuss career. No.
What happened was my father wanted us to get married immediately because I am finishing my internship, and
that's too early.
Then, but he told I want to get MCH and then only marry. So then where he'll be going for MCH and everything, because I was just studying for the entrance exams then. So he used to tell I want to go to Hyderabad or PGI only, or AIMS. Okay. These are the three choices like that. So I'm okay with that. I haven't left Madurai since I was born, so it was okay with me for
new places, something interesting. So then how did you get into Nizam Institute?
That is also fortunately I went to Nizam Institute.
You are fortunate here.
Fortunate.
Why? How?
No, actually during my general surgery program, I was at the end of the program. It was we are preparing for the exams, and suddenly I saw I was searching for a DNB. What is my next career? Because I was not keen in doing MMC or Madurai. Because it's not like I don't want to do. During in Madurai, during my residency, there will be 3 months only open cardiac surgery will be happen, because the consumables will be, after 9 months, it will be only closed cardiac surgeries.
Really?
Because of the funding issues or something.
Okay.
Because whatever they fund, they allot for annual funding, 3-4 months, it will be over. Disposables, it will be over. So after that, they will be doing closed mitral valvectomy, lung surgeries, and so there too. There also MCH program was there, and probably MMC it will be somehow better long
little
term,
bit.
Little better. So seeing that program, I thought we have to do daily something like that. Institute is the better. I want to. So those time now we want to do more surgeries. It's like more exposure. We like learning exposure. Now it's not like childish only, but it will be like those time we want to do more surgeries. We have to expose more towards the thing, surgical work like that. So I was thinking of AIMS, PGI, Chitra Tirunal.
These are the top institutions.
These are the AIMS and Chitra Tirunal are the topmost institutions in cardiac surgery.
Okay.
So we're thinking of that. Those entrances will come in. I was trying to apply for the January exam, entrance exam for AIMS, but they didn't accept me because my course will end in March.
Okay.
So my course completion will be March, so I am not eligible for that.
Right.
I was planning to apply for DNB in certain institutions, certain Coimbatore, a lot of institutions doing DNB cardiac program also. I inquired, there very good programs are there. So I was applied for that also. There also the cutoff date was the problem.
Okay.
So I was searching whenever there is a thing. That time steadily we will be studying, whole day we'll be studying, and some will have fun in the hostel or seeing the newspaper will read most. Books will study fastly and newspaper will read. During that time, it will be boring. They will be seeing 1 hour, they will be reading the newspapers. There, I got a small ad at Nizam Institute of Medical Science, Hyderabad. They are senior residents for various specialties, cardiac, anesthesiology, GI surgery, like that. Yes, sir. Non-PG, yes, sir. So I thought, okay, 500 rupees application, they are told, and see the website and download application, get a DD and send. So just like that, I applied that. I forget that also. I just applied. And forget, suddenly one day telegram is coming, day after tomorrow you have a 11 o'clock you have interview.
Who was the director at that time?
Director Dr. Prasad Rao. He's supposed to be a cardiac surgeon.
What is supposed to be? A famous cardiac surgeon.
Yeah, that's only right. It was. So Suddenly I got one day, find it was there. First time I have to rush for the interview because I have to travel from here to Chennai, Chennai, Hyderabad bus, because train is also not an option.
That's
that
right,
time.
Yeah.
So we went there and early morning, 4 o'clock I reached there, I booked a nearby one hotel and freshen up, and 11 o'clock I went to interview. Dr. Dharmakshak also accompanied in the interview.
Because of cardiac surgery.
HOD was there that time. They were asking some question, I don't know what I answered. But they told, after coming out, Dharmakshak inquired me, when is your course is completing? He was asked me, sir, before 31st March it will be over, sir. Okay, you call me and you can come, you can take my number.
Oh, okay.
He told, he was so like that, he was telling me, whenever you finish, just give me a ring. And if you are okay, you can join. He told, he announced the result. That
so your interview must have been very good.
Huh?
If you are not answering that properly, why will it take
it's
now?
Not like that. The department is shortage of very residents.
So that Andhra is there is so many people.
So they are very shortage of residents, and so some of the MCH teachers felt vacant. They are very, they needed people
okay.
at a residence level. So that maybe that also reason.
So how was your tenure in Nizam Institute? How was the training, or how was your stay? How was the work?
It was good. I was. It was like different world. It was looked to me. Here we'll be working from morning 8 or some 7:30 to during general surgery. One maximum 2 o'clock will be free, and during non OT days it will be less work only. There it will be morning 8 to 8, it will be continuous work, will
right.
be there, and all day will be OT. And institute is different from medical right. colleges, so
okay.
it was little bit hectic, and I enjoyed that.
Really?
I enjoyed okay. that, and okay. 2 months I was working there as a SR. During that time I was preparing for AIMS, PGA entrances, May entrances.
SR, non-PG?
Non-PG, yeah.
Okay.
It was non-PG SR.
Oh,
and
okay.
It's for non-PG SR, it's not like…
Not MCH.
Not MCH. Because anyway, till May, I won't get any options.
Right.
The super specialty program will open up, entrances will open up, and all the entrances will be in the pertinent specialty. Now, not like nowadays, general surgery, it will be like cardiac surgery, questions will be there in cardiac surgery. So, I thought it will be a good opportunity, learning opportunity, and I can walk through the entrance also. I will start simultaneously, there are a lot of people helping me, assistant professors, Dr. Amrish was there, he was helping me, and what to read for the entrance, what book you can read, Sebastian is there, he was suggesting this.
So, the atmosphere in Tanjore, Madurai is different and NIMS is different. I'm not trying to downplay anything.
It's slightly different. There the pro there you have a lot of volume, and there is protocol and working hours basically.
Okay.
Working hours is very demanding working.
Right.
When I started working Nizams, every third day will be duty, 24 hours duty.
Right.
And you'll be till next, if I come today morning 8 o'clock and tomorrow night 8 o'clock, I'll be leaving. Till
right,
that time, I'll
right.
be keep somewhere between them, night also.
You liked it.
And maybe the work I liked, I enjoyed the work,
okay.
I liked it.
Okay. When did you get into MCH?
By there, Nizam Institute, only Andhra people are allowed. During that period, no outsiders are MCH. I was not planning to do MCH there at all.
Oh, okay.
Because I won't get it all.
Oh, okay.
Only the seat felt vacant, they will open to all India quota. So I was preparing for AIMS, PGA, and Chitra Tirunal only entrance is December. So
right.
Chitra Tirunal is out of question.
Okay.
So AIMS and PGA. AIMS I didn't crack. PGA just I got rank and good rank entry also. I got first rank in PGA and I joined in PGA.
MCH.
And Dharmakshak was not allowing me. He was telling that we are going to start DNB program also. You can join DNB, you continue here itself. He was telling. But at that time, I want to do MCH because I don't want to waste years. And I want to get married also because there is something is back also, pressure is there for me. So whenever I got to marry, I have to be in institute there. One of the reason I don't want to join Tamil Nadu also, that is the thing. The stipend is very less.
Yes.
Here compared to that 1.5 times, 2 times more the thing, stipend is there.
Yes.
So that I can support
family.
If I marry somebody.
Right,
So So that is also one of the thing issues. So I joined in PG.
PG.
Okay. I joined in PG. Here also Nizams, I was staying in the hostel. They immediately, the Dr. Dharmashek called and I informed the hostel. They gave him a room. Once I joined, it was not like cakewalk here only. I just came with the bag and I joined. I went as a roommate to another person in the hostel. It was good. Everything was good. So like PG also, I went there, I joined the PG. After 1 week, 10 days, I got little bit, because I was working in the atmosphere in Nizams. It's not like PG is, the atmosphere was different and the workload, I feel less than Nims. Cardiac department.
The language, the climate, the food.
Language, climate, I food, I okay. Because Hyderabad also, it's different for me. It's around me. I know Hindi, I was studying Hindi during my Dakshina Bharati Hindi, Prachar Sabha school, Praveen I finished, so Hindi was not a problem. Even first 2 months I was managing with Hindi only in Hyderabad also. So there language is not a problem and lot of my juniors were there.
My mother, Nims?
No, it's not.
Chandigarh there will be.
PGA, lot of Tanjavur people, lot of Madurai, my interns was there. So I was feel hostel and all very good for me PGA, but the department somehow I was not convinced to 3 years there in that department, and there also a lot of people convinced, okay, you join, why you don't leave like that. But there also within 1 month if I leave, somebody can join. After 1 month if I leave, that seat will become vacant or something. Okay. So I thought I have to make a decision whether to continue here or not continue here. So I made a decision, I will quit the course. There I leave, there NIMS also I resigned and came, and here also I resigned and I was sitting in the home for 10-15 days. I don't know what to do. And that time...
How will you get married?
That's only... No, but I didn't like the thing. If I don't like the thing, I don't force myself to do the thing. So I came home and 15 days I was a little bit depressed and what to do. At that time, exactly Tamil Nadu counseling happened. My father and mother, okay, that time also second or third rank, I was third rank, I think. It was there in MCH, you can take MMC or Madurai, definitely I will get. If I go, I will take, so I didn't went to the counselling at all. So Tamil Nadu counselling. I was sitting in the home only at that time. And so, because if I go there, my mind will change, I was thinking. So I was there. I was trying to, one of my mentors, a friend, Dr. in Ramachandra was there, Dr. Sevamuthukumar, he's a cardiac surgeon.
Okay.
Dr. Sevamuthukumar is a cardiac surgeon.
Short.
Yeah.
I know him.
Yeah, he's a cardiac surgeon.
Okay.
He was doing MCH in Madurai when I was doing MS.
Okay.
So he's like, I will be discussing cardiac surgery with him. He will also encourage me to do, okay. He only told me that don't do in Tamil Nadu.
Really?
You do in studio. Told me to do in AIMS, Chitrai Thirunal, and like that you will be to, you prepare for that. Those are good institutions like that. So I asked him what to do, sir. I was, you come Ramachandra, I am there. You come, you work as a SR, you can work as a SR there. No problem. I will talk to my HOD.
But KRB was there. Who was there?
KRB sir.
Okay.
KRB sir and Richard Chalna, another doctor.
Right.
Both of them are there. I will talk to them. You can work. They will be interested to take you. And if you feel comfortable, you can join MCH also. It's vacant here only. But he told 3 lakhs per annum fees. You just pay the fee. Tuition fee. You can join. No, sir. I can't afford it. 3 lakhs. So you can join us, sir, if you want. So I was in the process of doing that. That time my call came from Nizams that they are opening for one seat, 3 seat. Two of them joined and one is vacant. They are making 1 seat All India open for All India. So one of my senior over there, he was a resident, Dr. Bipin. He was doing there. He called me. Hey, come here. Entrance is there. You can, there only entrance is there,
right,
no
right.
Interview is there. So right. you will crack. So I went to the hostel again 1-3 days before itself. I prepared further again for the Nizam entrance. So that is also a little bit tricky situation only. If somebody from Andhra got qualified, even 50%.
I mean, the huge risks you are taking, you are not taking the Tamil Nadu thing, you're just leaving it. But if you, there's a chance only if you're getting.
Yeah, there only one seat is there. Even if I get the first rank, somebody from Andhra got 50% qualification mark, even they got 7th or 8th rank, they will be selected. Mm. That is the rules over there now. So even I want to take the risk. That time I got the thing, like only 4 people came. One of them is Andhra. Other 3 are non, 2 of them from Maharashtra or something. So that one fellow, if got qualified, he will be the candidate to be selected. There I got the first rank and that fellow is not qualified. So 3 ranks was released.
Okay.
Both the 3 of us was non-Andhraites and okay. I got the first rank, I got the seat.
Yeah. So felt happy about it.
Felt happy about
obviously, it. Obviously, Dharma Rakshak and others helped you, you know, whatever.
No, there it's the interview that they have a great chance, but there is no interview. Only thing.
Okay, you got MCH, then got married.
Yeah,
second year.
First year will be hectic, I know that.
But is that money enough to run a family?
It will be fair enough.
Uh-huh. And see, cardiac thoracic surgery is day and night surgery. Mm-hmm. Cardiac thoracic surgery should not marry. See, because I remember when I was doing a gastro, Dr. Vijay Shankar used to sleep in between ICU beds, this bed. They never went. In Jipmo Pondicherry, for 5 days they never used to go home.
That's true.
But when you got married in a new place, new language, new surroundings, a husband is not coming home. Yeah. Is it okay?
It was a bit difficult, but then that was a quarters type of thing.
Okay.
So his fellow PGs were also staying there.
Okay.
Their wives, everybody were there. So day fully, I'll be occupied with them.
Uh-huh.
I'll go to their house and
okay.
something. Nights will be difficult because I've never stayed alone in my life. So. Initially
that is sacrifice,
it was difficult.
Really.
Yeah.
You never used to bug him, upset him, and what is this, you're not coming?
No. From that time, I felt if he goes to work and be happy, that is enough.
Oh, that's a great thing.
So, I also started a work in one of the hospitals, Vikram Hospital, as
okay.
a doctor.
Okay.
Because till he's there, I can't do a PG there because in Andhra, other state candidates cannot do
right,
PG.
Yes.
So we thought he'll finish his PG, then maybe I can do something.
Mm-hmm.
So till then I'll occupy with something. So I was going to work daily.
Okay.
So it was
that
like
kept you occupied.
Occupied and.
So there's no much problem at home coming
yeah.
back.
No, actually I discussed before marriage only. I told her that I'll be doing cardiac surgery. His life will be like that.
That's
if you're okay, just marry me. I discussed issues already with her and she knows that. Life will be demanding and challenging.